नमस्ते, दिस इज रमेश नायडू फ्रॉम टारगेट स्कूल. टुडे टॉपिक मेंसुरेशन पार्ट 10 फॉर 9th एंड 10th क्लास स्टूडेंट्स, राइट. सो इन दिस पार्ट वी डिस्कस अबाउट शॉर्ट आंसर टाइप प्रॉब्लम्स, राइट. लेट बी द फर्स्ट प्रॉब्लम. फाइंड द एरिया ऑफ फोर वॉल्स ऑफ ए रूम. ऑब्जर्व केयरफुली. फाइंड द एरिया ऑफ four walls of a room. If length of room is 12 meters and breadth is 8 meters and its height is 5 meters. Observe carefully. Area of four walls means lateral surface area of cuboid. So every room is in the shape of cuboid, right? So a room is in the shape of cuboid. In that lateral surfaces are four. So in the four walls are lateral surfaces, right? LSA. LSA of room are area of four walls. Here room is in cuboid shape. LSA of cuboid. Right? Here room is in cuboid shape. LS of cuboid formula. Lateral surface area of cuboid. 2H into L plus B. Right? So LS of cuboid means area of four walls is 2H of L plus B. Now substitute L, B, H values in it. 2H. H means the height. 5 meters. Into L plus B. L is 12 and B is 8. 12 plus 8. Right? That is equal to 2 5s are 10 into 12 plus 8 20. 20 tens are 200 meters square. So 200 meters square, that is area of 4 walls. Therefore area of 4 walls of room is 200 meters square. Right? Next, go for second problem. Observe carefully. If TSA, TSA means total surface area. Total surface area of cube is 2400. TSA of cube is 2400 square meters. Then find its volume. To find volume, we must need its edge. There is no edge, but they given total surface area of cube. So we know very well the formula TSA of cube. TSA of cube is 6a square. So but in the problem 6a square value, 6a square is equal to 2400 given, right? So TSA given, TSA is 6A square, that is equal to 2400, right? Then A square is equal to 2400 into 6 will become by 6. 6 ones are 6 400s are, right? That is equal to 400. A square is equal to 400. Then what about the A value? A is equal to root 400. Square root of 400 is 20. 20 meters. So A is edge of cube. Now we can find its volume. So therefore, volume of cube is equal to volume of cube formula A cube. Right? So that is A. We know A value. A is 20. Substituting it. 20 cube. That is equal to 20 cube means 20 raised 3 times. 20 into 20 into 20. That is equal to 8000 meter cube. So that is the volume of cube, right? So when given TSA, we can find its edge. Edge of cube, that is A or S. We can make S also. x is equal to 20, then volume is equal to a cube, 20 cube. 20 cube means 8000, right? Go for next problem. Find the radius of a sphere. So here we need to find radius of sphere whose surface area is 154 centimeter square. So in this problem they given surface area of a sphere, right? Then find the its radius. So we know very well surface area of a sphere. Right, CSR sphere. Is equal to formula CSR sphere 4 pi r square. But according to the problem, 4 pi r square surface area is 154. Right. Now from this we can find r value. Right. 4 into pi can be written as 22 by 7. Pi its approximate value is 22 by 7 into r square is equal to 154. Then r square is equal to 154 into, see, into 4 will become by 4 into 22 by 7 will become 7 by 22, right? That's it. Now cancel it. With 11. 11 2s are 22. 11 1s 11. 4 is there. 11 4s are. Right? Again. 2 1s. 2 7s are 14. So r square is equal to 7 7s are 49 by 4. Right? Then r is equal to square root of 49 by 4, that is equal to root 49, 7 by root 4, 2. 7 by 2 is 3.5 centimeters. So radius r is equal to, radius of sphere r is equal to 3.5 centimeters, right? So here, once again, listen, in this they given surface area, right? Surface area formula 4 pi r square. 4 pi r square is equal to 154 given. So from this we get r value, right? Go for next two problem. The volume of a cuboid, observe carefully, the volume of a cuboid is 1200 centimeter cube, whose length of cuboid is 15 and the breadth is 10. Then find the height, it's a height. So here we need to find the height of cuboid. So in this problem they given volume given. So volume of cuboid formula, volume of cuboid V is equal to LBH, L into B into H. Volume of cuboid formula V is equal to LBH. But according to the problem, LBH value given, the volume is 1200, right? And also L given, B given, substitute here. L is 15, B is 10. 15 into 10 into H, we don't know H, spread as this, 1200, right? So here we want H only, then H is equal to 1200 divided by 15 into 10 will become divided by 15 into 10, right? So 1010 cancel, 15 ones are 15, 8s are. H is equal to 8 centimeters. H is height of cuboid, therefore height is equal to 8 centimeters. Height of cuboid is 8 centimeters, right? Yes, go for next two problem. The volume of cone is 462. The volume of cone is 462 centimeter cube and its radius is 7 centimeters. So volume given, radius given. Then find its height. So what is the height of the cone? Yes. Here the solid is cone. Right? So in this problem they given radius given, r is equal to 7. Radius of cone means base radius of cone. And the volume also given, b is equal to 462 centimeter cube. Then what is its height? So we know volume formula. Volume formula, what is it? Volume of cone is 1 by 3 pi r square h. This is equal to 462, right? Now substitute r value here. 1 by 3 into pi. It's a mirror value. 22 by 7 into r square. R is 7. 7 into 7. R square can be written as r into r. R raised 2 times. 7 into 7 into h is equal to 462, right? Here 1717 get cancelled. So what is remaining? 22 into 7 by 3 divided by 3. 22 into 7 divided by 3 into h is equal to 462. So here we want h only. Then h is equal to 462 into 22 into 7 by 3 will become reverse. After transferring from left to right, 22, 3 by 22 into 7. 22 into 7, right? Now cancel them. 11 2s are 22, 11 4s are 44, 2 is there, 11 2s are, right? Again, 2 1s are. 2 2s are 2 1s are. 7 1s are 7 3s are. 3 into 3. H is equal to 3 3s are 9 centimeters. Right? It is height of cone. Height of cone H is 9 centimeters. Right? So in this problem, R given and volume given. By using volume formula, we can get height. Right? That's it. Go for next problem. So it is very interesting problem and important also. Height of two cylinders are equal. It is cylinder 1 and it is cylinder 2. So there are two cylinders. Observe carefully. There are two cylinders. The first cylinder and the second cylinder. The height of two cylinders are equal. So, h is equal to h. Here also h is equal to h. So, height are same. Height are equal, right? And the radii are capital R and smaller. Its radius is capital R and its radius is smaller, right? Then, their ratios of volumes. So, we need to find out the ratio of their volumes. So its volume V1 is equal to volume of the first cylinder. What is the volume of cylinder? Pi R square H. Pi, here radius is capital R. Capital R square H. H is same. Right? Here volume V2 is equal to volume of second cylinder is equal to pi R square. R is smaller. Smaller square H. H. Right? Now, the ratio of these two volumes. Therefore, V1 is to V2. The ratio of volumes of the two cylinders. It is volume of first cylinder. It is volume of second cylinder. V1 is to V2 is equal to V1. Pi R square H is to pi small r square H. In this, pi pi cancel, HH also cancel. The remaining is capital R square is to small r square. That is the required ratio. See, one second, listen. If the heights of two cylinders are equal, then the ratio of their volumes is capital R square is to small r square, right? The square of radius of first cylinder is 2, the square of radius of second cylinder. Let's go for next two problem. The base of a prism is an equilateral triangle. In equilateral triangle, all sides are equal, right? The base of the prism, here the solid is prism. The base of the prism is in which shape? Equilateral triangle of side of 6 centimeters, right? And its height is 10 centimeters. Find its volume. So here we need to find the volume of prism, right? Here the solid is prism, right? So the prism is in, the base is in which form? Equilateral triangle, right? So it is called a equilateral triangular prism. Equilateral triangular prism. So side of base. Is equal to 6 centimeters. It may say A is equal to 6 centimeters, right? And the height means the height of prism, height of prism, h is equal to 10 centimeters. Then its volume is equal to. So we know very well formula, volume is equal to A into h. A into H. A means area of base. Area of base. The base of prism is in which shape? Equilateral triangle, right? So we know very well, area of an equilateral triangle is root 3 A square by 4. So area of base, root 3 A square by 4. So area of base is root 3 A square by 4. Here the base is in which form? Equilateral triangular form. So area of equilateral triangle is root 3 a square by 4 into h, into h, right? Here a is the side of base, 6, substitute here. Root 3 into a square, a means 6, 6 into 6, 6 square, 6 square means 6 into 6 by 4 into h value, height of prism 10, right? Now cancel it. 2 2's are, 2 5's are. Again, 2 1's, 2 3's. The final answer is 5 3's are 15, 15 6's are 90. 90 root 3, right? Centimeters. It is volume centimeter cube. So, units of volume centimeter cube, right? Don't forget. Go for next problem. So it is also one of the interesting problem. How many liters of milk can a hemispherical bowl? Here the bowl is in which shape? Hemispherical bowl, right? Of diameter 10.5 centimeters hold. See? So here the spherical bowl can hold how many liters of milk? That is the question. So here we find its volume, right? Volume of hemispherical bowl. So here the solid is hemispherical bowl. Bowl that is in which shape? Hemispherical shape, right? So diameter given, diameter D is equal to 10.5 centimeters. Then what is the radius? So radius is half of diameter. Means 10.5/2. That is equal to, it can be written as 105/20, right? So 5 4s are 20, 5 2s are 5 1s are. So R is equal to 21/4 centimeters. So radius of bowl is 21/4. Now volume of bowl is equal to, volume V is equal to, volume of hemispherical bowl 2/3 pi r cube. That is volume formula. Now substitute here, that is equal to 2/3 into pi value, 22/7 into r cube. R raised 3 times. R is 21/4. 21 by 4 raised 3 times. 21 by 4 into 21 by 4, right? So after simplifying this, we get 303.187. 303.187 centimeter cube. After recurring, it can be written as 303.187. After recurring, we get to 19. It can be written as 19. This 187 here to 19, right? This centimeter cube. Now, how to convert into liters? If we divide this with 1000, it convert into liters, right? That is equal to 303.19/1000 liters. That is equal to 0.303 liters, right? So 1 centimeter cube is equal to 1000 liters. So after dividing 1000, we get 0.303 liters. So the bowl hold 0.303 liters of milk, right? Yes, go for next problem. It is also one of the important problem. Observe carefully. The diameter of a spherical balloon. Here the balloon is in spherical shape, right? Increases from 14 centimeter to 28 centimeters. Observe carefully. The diameter of a spherical balloon is increases from 14 centimeter to 28 centimeters as air is being pumped, right? So before pumping the air, the diameter is 14. After pumping the air, the diameter is 28 centimeters, right? Find the ratio of surface areas of the balloon in two cases. So there are two cases. The first one, before pumping the air. The second one, after pumping the air, right? Case 1. It is case 2. Right? In the case 1, the diameter is 14. D is equal to 14 centimeters. After pumping the air, the diameter is 28 centimeters. Right? After pumping the air, the diameter is increased. That is 14 to 28. Before pumping, after pumping, that is a spherical shape, right? So D in first case, D is equal to 14, then R is equal to half of diameter. 14 by 2, that is equal to 7 centimeters. In second case, R is equal to half of diameter. 28 by 2, that is equal to 14 centimeters, right? So in first case, its surface area means CSA of balloon. CSA of balloon 4 pi r square, right? 4 pi r square, r is 7, 7 square.
equal to 4 pi 7 square 49, right? That is equal to 4 pi into 49. So write as is 4 into pi into 49 centimeter square. So in first case, that is before pumping the air, the CSC of balloon is 4 into pi into 49 centimeter square. Next, in case 2, after pumping the air, its CSA is equal to 4 pi r square. That is equal to 4 into pi into r square. R is 14. 14 into 14, right? That is equal to 4 into pi into 14. 14 is 196. Right? Centimeter square. So it is before pumping the air, it's CSA. It is after pumping the air, it's CSA. Now we have to find in both cases the ratio of surfaces, that is required ratio. Therefore, required ratio is equal to, in first case, 4 pi into 49, right, is 2. In second case, 4 pi into 196, right? So, in both, 4 pi get cancelled. Next to 7 7s are 49, 7 2s are 40, 5 is there, 8s are. Right? Again, 7 1s are 7 4s are. So, required ratio is 1 is to 4. Right? That is the required ratio. So go for next problem. A right circular cylinder just encloses a sphere as shown in the figure. See? So that it is a sphere and it is a cylinder. Yes? Of radius r. Its radius is r. It is also r. Right? Here radius of sphere is r and the radius of base of cylinder also r. Then find the CSC of sphere and CSC of cylinder. What do you observe? Observe carefully. So there are two solids. The first one is sphere, second one is cylinder. The first one is sphere. Next one is cylinder. Right? So what is the radius of sphere? R is equal to R. Right? Then it's a CSC. CSA sphere 4 pi r square, right? Here r is equal to r, right as this. And the CSA of cylinder. So, what is the radius of cylinder r? What is the height of cylinder? Observe carefully. Here, a cylinder is encloses a sphere. So, it is the height of cylinder. So, in sphere, it is radius, it is also radius. So, R plus R gives height of cylinder. So, H is equal to R plus R, 2R. Height of cylinder is 2R, right? So, height of cylinder H is equal to 2R and its radius R is equal to R. Then, it's a CSA. Curved surface area cylinder. Pi R square H. CSA of cylinder formula pi R square H. That is equal to pi, r means r, r square, H means 2R into 2R. Sorry. CS of cylinder 2 pi RH. Yes, that is volume. So volume is pi R square H formula. But CS of cylinder is 2 pi RH. Right? So CS of cylinder is 2 pi RH. 2 pi R is R into H is 2R. Right? That is equal to 2 2s are 4. R into R, R square. 4 pi R square. Right? So, in these two cases, the two CSS are equal. So, what do you observe means? CSC of sphere is equal to CSC of cylinder. Right? We observe that. We observe that CSA of sphere is equal to CSA of cylinder, right? So, formulas are very, very important. Formulas must keep in our mind. So, if we know formula, we can find any surface area and volume and total surface area. See? So, don't forget, CSA of cylinder is 2 pi R H. So, volume is pi R square H, right?